ഹലോ എല്ലാവർക്കും നമസ്കാരം. ഓക്കെ, നമ്മൾ സെഷൻ 11 മണിക്ക് തന്നെ തുടങ്ങാം. അപ്പോൾ ഞാൻ ഇന്ന് ഇന്ന് ഇപ്പം നിങ്ങൾ ഓരോരുത്തരും എവിടെ നിന്നാണ് ലൊക്കേഷൻ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു തുടങ്ങണമെങ്കിൽ എനിക്ക് മനസ്സിലാവും എന്താണ് നിങ്ങൾ എവിടെ നിന്നാണ് വരുന്നത് എന്നൊക്കെ ഉള്ളത്. സോ എല്ലാവരും കേൾക്കുന്നുണ്ട് ഞാനീ പറയുന്നത്. കേൾക്കുന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ചാറ്റ് റൂമിൽ ഒരു ഹായ് പറയാം, യെസ് എന്ന് പറയാം. ഇനി അതല്ല, ഹലോ, ഞാൻ സംസാരിക്കുന്നത് കേൾക്കുന്നുണ്ടോ എല്ലാവർക്കും? യാ, വെരി ഗുഡ്. ഓക്കെ, താങ്ക്സ് നവീൻ. ഓക്കെ 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 നിങ്ങൾ ഓക്കെ, കുവൈറ്റ്. ഓക്കെ, ഗുഡ് 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 ഗുഡ്. ഹലോ സാർ, ഗുഡ് മോർണിംഗ്. Sir, we need to.
Yeah. You are able to hear me, right?
Yes, perfect. You can hear me as well, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. I'll just put it in a gallery mode.
No issues. Yeah.
That's it. So we have already about 27 people has joined.
Oh, okay.
Then we will start the session at 11 itself.
Sure.
Okay. So just
check the share screen.
Yeah, just you.
Yeah.
One second. I have given the permission to you.
Okay.
So just try to see that if it's. Yeah, perfect.
Perfect. So, yeah, right.
As the session start, I will go for. So only you and the screen will come up.
ठीक है. That's right.
So people can just mention that where you are from, so we will able to understand that which location you guys are coming from. If you want to mention that, okay, yeah, good, good. So people from Kuwait, okay. One person said that, a couple of people said that they can't hear me. Can you just confirm again if you are able to hear us? Okay. Okay, very good, very good. I think there are a couple of people said that. I think Vijin, can you hear me? So I think mainly people are from Middle East.
Okay.
Anyone from Kerala, Ireland? Just say hi. Okay. Okay, from Ireland. Okay, so it's a. Early morning for you. Thank you for joining us. Nice. We are just recording the session.
Oh yeah.
Good morning. Sujit from Chennai.
Hi.
Okay. Chandu and Vijin, if you can confirm whether you are able to hear us, that will be great.
Vijin can't hear, it seems. Vijin, would you mind? Okay, I'll just type in. Would you mind just re-log in?
Yeah. Maybe now you have to accept when you say ki. It asks for.
Not able to hear. Please.
I think it will ask for internet audio or something. You have to accept that.
I think this is okay. I'll just type in and say that.
But Chandu, what you do is you accept that internet audio, you accept that. I think we have to send a message to him only.
In case issue, please re-log in. Okay, when you I think when they re-log in, I think they have to accept that internet audio.
Audio, that is one.
Yeah.
Second is let them also select a microphone same as system and select a speaker also same as system.
Uh-huh. Then you can do just type in and say that.
I'll say that.
Denil is our IT person. So Denil, just type in and say that re-log in and use that audio, internet audio, right? Okay. I think Vijin is re-login. I think now he will be able to hear. Yeah, it's working.
It's working, huh? Okay. Yeah. Oh, great. Okay.
I think it's now it's 11 o'clock. We will kickstart the meeting. I'll just give a short intro for 2 minutes. So, hi everyone. Thank you all for okay. I'm Adi Malayalathil parayam. Adi ganeethu I will. So, just ellavarkku namaskaram. Appa valare sandosham ellavarum join cheyidana. Appa innatha session korchum kudiyum vyathyasayittu innu nammalopam ഗസ്റ്റ് സ്പീക്കർ ആയിട്ട് ഗുരുവായ സാർ ഉണ്ട്. അപ്പോൾ ഇന്നത്തെ ഒരു കാര്യം പറയണമെന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ നമ്മൾ റിട്ടയർ വീഡിയോയിൽ പറഞ്ഞ മാതിരിയും അതേപോലെ തന്നെ ഓഡിയോ നമ്മുടെ പോസ്റ്ററിൽ പറഞ്ഞ മാതിരിയും റിട്ടയർമെന്റിനെ കുറിച്ചിട്ടാണ് നമ്മൾ മെയിനായിട്ട് സംസാരിക്കാൻ പോകുന്നത്. അപ്പോൾ ഇന്നത്തെ ഒരു കാര്യം പറഞ്ഞാൽ സെഷൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷിലായിരിക്കും. ഞാൻ സംസാരിക്കുന്ന സമയത്തും ഇംഗ്ലീഷും മലയാളം കൂടി മിക്സ് ചെയ്തിട്ട് സംസാരിക്കും. അപ്പോൾ ആദ്യത്തെ ഒരു സെഷൻ പറഞ്ഞ ആദ്യമൊരു ഞാൻ ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്യും ഗുരുരായ സാറിന്. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ടൊരു ഒരു 15-20 മിനിറ്റ്സ് ഗുരുരായ സാറിൻ്റെ ഒരു പ്രസൻറ്റേഷൻ ഉണ്ടാവും റിട്ടയർമെന്റിനെ കുറിച്ചൊരു ഡീറ്റെയിൽ ആയിട്ട്. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ട് നമ്മൾ ഒരു ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ആൻസർ സെഷൻ ഞാനും ഗുരുരായ സാറും ഒരു ഡിസ്കഷൻ സംസാരിക്കും. എന്തൊക്കെയാണ് ഒരു റിട്ടയർമെന്റ് എന്നുള്ള രീതിയിൽ ഒരു ജനറലി ഉള്ള ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ചോദിച്ചുണ്ട്. അതിനുശേഷം ഒരു 11:45 ആകുമ്പോൾ അടുത്തൊരു 15 മിനിറ്റ്സ് കഴിയുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കുമായിട്ട് ക്യു എൻ എ സെഷൻ നമുക്ക് ഓർഗനൈസ് ചെയ്യാം. ഇതാണ് ഇന്നത്തെ ഷോർട്ട് അജണ്ട. അപ്പോൾ ഇന്ന് വി ആർ വെരി ഫോർച്ചുനേറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് നമുക്ക് ഇന്ന് വളരെ എക്സ്പീരിയൻസ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു ഏകദേശം ഒരു 30 വർഷത്തിന് മേലെ എക്സ്പീരിയൻസ് ഉള്ള മ്യൂച്വൽ ഫണ്ടിൽ തന്നെ സ്പെസിഫിക് ആയിട്ട് 27 ഇയേഴ്സിന് മുകളിൽ എക്സ്പീരിയൻസ് ഉള്ള ഗുരുരായ സാറാണ് നമ്മുടെ ഉള്ളത്. ഇദ്ദേഹം ചെന്നൈയിലാണ്. സോ ഹി വിൽ അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് മലയാളം, പക്ഷേ ഹി ഹാസ് ടു സ്പീക്ക്. So I will be the bridge between in case namak aarengilku malayalathil chodikkanundengil njan sarinte adut english il choichittu choichollu allengil njan just cheruthayittu translate cheythu nammal cheyidollam. Appo adheham assistant vice president aanu Aditya Birla Sun Life AMC il. Adodoppo nenna ee training nulla oru pratheka ee division thanneyanu adheham handle cheyyunnathu. ആദിത്യ ബിർളയിൽ 2008 ജോയിൻ ചെയ്തത്. പക്ഷെ അതിനു മുന്നായാലും മ്യൂച്വൽ ഫണ്ടിൽ പല പല AMC കൾക്ക് വേണ്ടി പല പല കമ്പനികൾക്ക് വേണ്ടിയിട്ടും ട്രെയിനിങ് ആയിട്ടും അതേമാതിരി ഒത്തിരി റോളുകൾ റിസർച്ച് ആയിട്ടും അതേമാതിരി ബിസിനസ് ഡെവലപ്മെൻ്റ് ആയിട്ടും റിസർച്ച് ആൻഡ് ഡെവലപ്മെൻ്റ് ആയിട്ട് അഡ്മിൻ ആയിട്ടും ആയിട്ടും ഒത്തിരി കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഇൻ ആൻഡ് ഔട്ട് മ്യൂച്വൽ ഫണ്ടിനെ കുറിച്ചിട്ട് ഉള്ള കാര്യങ്ങൾ ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ളത്. അപ്പോൾ ഇദ്ദേഹം സ്റ്റാറ്റിസ്റ്റിക്സിലാണ് എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ ചെയ്തേക്കുന്നത്. ലയോള കോളേജ് നമ്മുടെ എല്ലാ ഇപ്പം മിക്ക ആൾക്കാർക്ക് ലയോള കോളേജ് ഒരു ഡ്രീം കോളേജ് ആയിരിക്കും ചെന്നൈയിൽ നിന്ന്. അവിടെയാണ് അദ്ദേഹം പഠിച്ചിട്ടുള്ളത്. അപ്പോൾ ഇന്ന് നമ്മൾ സ്പെസിഫിക് ആയിട്ട് സംസാരിക്കാൻ പോകുന്നത് റിട്ടയർമെന്റിനെ കുറിച്ചാണ്. അപ്പോൾ സാറ് ഇനി അടുത്ത ഒരു 20 മിനിറ്റ്സ് റിട്ടയർമെന്റിനെ കുറിച്ച് സ്പെസിഫിക് ആയിട്ട് ഒരു സെഷൻ നമുക്ക് റൺ ചെയ്യാൻ പോകണം. സോ സെഷൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷിലായിരിക്കും. ദെൻ ഡിസ്കഷൻ കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ട് നമ്മൾ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ആൻസർ സെഷൻ ആവുക. ഇൻ കേസ് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എന്തെങ്കിലും ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ഓഡിയോ പ്രസ് ചെയ്യാണ്ട് നിങ്ങളുടെ ചാറ്റിൽ ചോദിക്കുക. ഞങ്ങൾ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ആൻസർ സെഷനിലാവുമ്പോൾ വി വിൽ അതിൽ നിന്ന് പിക്ക് ചെയ്തിട്ട് നമ്മൾ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ആൻസർ സെഷൻ നടത്തുന്നതായിരിക്കും. ഓക്കെ, അപ്പോൾ ഓവർ ടു യു സർ. സോ
താങ്ക് യു. ഐ തിങ്ക് വിജിൻ സ്റ്റിൽ ഹാസ് എ പ്രോബ്ലം, സോ പ്രോബബ്ലി യു കാൻ ആസ്ക് ഹിം ടു text him. Vijin is still having some problem. Okay, I just saw the text. You can text him the same thing.
Yeah. I will just go on unvideo now.
Yeah. So good morning, friends, and nice to connect. And thanks to Nikhil sir for having arranged this program today. I mean, retirement planning is something which all of us should at least know how to plan for it. Yeah. Just a minute.
Yeah, over to you, sir. Yeah.
One second. I think it's some problem of.
Okay.
I'll just start it. Okay, yeah. So my humble request, you can keep it on mute, all of you. And in case you want to ask any questions, we'll obviously take it in the Q&A session. I can put it in the chat box. Whatever questions you can keep putting in the chat box and we'll answer at the end of the session. And today's topic is retirement planning. So let us start from there. Unfortunately, my apologies for not speaking in Malayalam because I don't know how to speak. As Nikhil said, I do understand, but I can't speak. In fact, the problem with me is whenever I land in Kerala, people will start talking to me in Malayalam because probably my face looks like a Malayali and then I find it very difficult to answer them. Yeah. So coming back, yeah. So I'll keep it in English. And of course, we have Nikhil today who can help us to translate. So don't worry about the questions. End of the session, you can always unmute and ask in Malayalam also. We'll reply to you. Don't worry about it. We have a translator with us today. So absolutely no issues on that. Yeah, coming back, we are going to talk about retirement planning. So first thing is we need to be clear. How do I define retirement, right? So retirement is not like saying that if I reach this age, I will retire. I mean, those days are gone. I still remember when my father retired, he came with a garland and a watch as a present, and that was his last day in office. So for us, many of us, retirement means we think that the last day of our work is retirement. I think today it has all changed now, right? Today, anybody can retire at any age. So it is more like, I will say, whatever you want to do, right? When you'll be able to do. That is what I call it as retirement, right? Whatever, see, each of us have some aspirations, right? We'll say, I want to do like this, I want to do that, I want to do this. See, whenever you can do it, that is the time for your retirement, right? So that is where I always feel, ki, don't go by age for retirement. It doesn't have anything. That's where I said it is not same for everyone. Because for each of us, it will be different. Somebody will retire at 55, somebody might work till 65, right? It all depends. So there is no fixed age for retirement. But when we talk of retirement, two things which we need to remember is there is an emotional aspect to retirement and a financial aspect to retirement. So the emotional aspect is nothing but what you're going to do after retirement, right? People start worrying, especially if you look at me, I'm almost 57. Another two and a half years, I'm going to retire. So already my thoughts are there, ki, what is that I should do after retirement, right? So that is one emotional aspect. Then the financial aspect, do I have enough money? So that once my salary stops coming, will I be able to survive? So that is the financial aspect. So there are two aspects. And of course, health is something which we need to take care. Honestly, last 2 years, I've been working very hard on my health. When I was a diabetic for almost 15, 16 years, and last 1.5 years, I'm not taking any medicine, right? Because I attended some program and because I knew post-retirement, the biggest challenge is going to be health. And trust me, I can run, and I've run now 21 kilometers also, though frequently I try to maintain 10 kilometers, right? So health is very important, man. We need to consider that because post-retirement, your health expenses is going to be really high, right? And when you don't have regular income, we'll be getting into trouble. All our savings cannot go towards our health, right? That is where you need to focus on health and start early. I mean, I started 2 years back only, but most of you should start now itself because so long as your health is good, I think your retirement will also be good. So two aspects, emotional and health and the financial aspect we need to consider. And many people ask, "Boss, why should I plan for my retirement?" The answer is simple. Because the moment you stop earning, boss, how we are going to manage your expenses? So it is not that you don't know when retirement is going to happen, right? You are clear at least. These days, any age above 50, you should be ready for retirement any day. Because you don't know whether your company will retain you till 60 or something. We are fortunate, maybe another 2 years we'll be able to work. But honestly, beyond 50, it is a question mark, right? So that's where very important. So if you are going to retire or you are forced to retire by 50, I need to have enough capital, right? So today, there is absolutely no guarantee you will work. Even in government offices today, people can be asked to go, right? So that is the status. So private, you need not even ask that question. So anytime people might just say, boss, thanks a lot. That is one challenge, right? So your job uncertainty is a challenge. Second biggest challenge is today, everybody is living till 80, which means effectively you are going to live for post-retirement of 20, 25 years, right? So if you don't plan and accumulate that corpus, it is going to be difficult. And the last point is very important. I still remember my parents were staying with each of our brothers, right? We were four kids all together, my sister and three brothers, right? So at least my parents were lucky. My father didn't have a house. So he used to stay with each of us, right? Now that kind of structure is not there today. Probably we have one child or maximum two children, right? And children will be working elsewhere. They may not like us to stay with them. I mean, all these are realities today. Today, please don't expect your children to take care of you. If you are depending on that, I mean, absolutely, we will be in for a shock, right? So never do that. That's why being financially independent is very important. That's the reason why we say retirement planning is important. And what we want to say here is, I mean, retirement, if for example, if somebody is starting at 25, retirement is at least 25 years away, right? Somebody is 40 years today, retirement is at least 10 years away, right? If not more than that. So the question here is, don't worry about what should I do, whether I have started late. Although you stop worrying about it, nothing like starting late. Start when today itself, right? Because if you have not done before, no harm in starting today at least. Don't delay it further. So that is one thing. And second is, all these are calculations, honestly, man. Today, if I have to plan how much capital I require, these are some calculations which we do, right? But all these calculations will be true when you are coming closer to retirement, right? For example, today I can tell how much corpus I need because I just have 2 years. Because I know about inflation, I know what is my expenses, right? Somebody who is 25 years old, if I ask him, boss, what will be your expenses at the age of 55, he will laugh at me, right? So that is where my job is only to focus on investing, right? As I come closer, somewhere around 50 years, that is where I'll have a lot of clarity. What is my expenses? How much I have to spend for other things? Because by the age of 50, most of your, focus like children's education or probably marriage, all these things might get over. So then you have a clarity how much you are going to spend. What is that amount you need? So all this clarity will come somewhere close to 50 and above. So till then, what you should do is just keep investing. Don't worry about other things, right? Whatever maximum you can save for it, just do that, right? And of course, the asset allocation, we'll talk to you about that also. And ensure that your health insurance policy is there. Very, very important, without which it will be difficult for us. So this is what I just want to show a couple of slides to explain my point. If you start early, what is the advantage, right? If you see here, to generate a corpus of 1 crore, if you are investing at the around 5,69,000 at the age of 45, you'll be able to achieve 1 crore, assuming you are getting 12%. But if you are starting at 35, the amount, see how much it comes down. This is what I am saying. Starting early is a huge advantage. Between 25 and 45, you see the amount, right? So sometimes people will get afraid. So much, I don't even have this much savings. How do I do it, right? So don't worry about it. That's where I said, make a beginning. And then as it goes, because life is not certain, right? Lot of uncertainty. So we have to start it. And then keep planning every year, right? We have to look back every year. That's the way we need to do it. Second important thing is not only starting early is important, where you are investing is equally important. For example, if I show you here, if I go and put money in a very safe place, if I get 8%, I need 2,18,000 per year to generate that 1 crore, assuming your age is 35, right? But if you are investing at a 12%, which is basically we say as a balanced category, 1,38,000 is required. But if you are investing in a good 15% kind of return, it is only 97. So two learnings is, one, start early and invest in the right place, right? These two are very important to decide the amount you have to invest, right? How do I build a corpus, man? The answer is simple. I'll just put it. All we need is we need to understand what will be our expenses in future, right? Simple, if I have to explain in two sentences, I need 1 lakh rupees per month after retirement. I'm just giving an example, right? Now, to generate that 1 lakh every month, which means for every year, 12 lakh rupees, right? Now, 12 lakh rupees I need every year. So, what is the corpus which at 6% or 5% will give me 12 lakhs? That is the simplest way to build a corpus, right? That's where I said first we need to know the expenses. So, if my annual expenses is 12 lakhs, right? So, by having a corpus of, let's say, 2 crore, right? If I give me 5% interest, I will get somewhere around 10 lakhs, right? So, which means if I invest at 6%, I'll be able to get that. So, I need 2 crores to have this, right? Now, 6% is without inflation. So, if I am going to consider inflation, my corpus is going to be higher, right? So, this is a very simple calculation to understand. Whatever you require, you take, if I put X amount at 6%, it should be equivalent to 12 lakhs. That is the simplest calculation, right? Which, of course, advisor Mr. Nikhil will also help you, right? And this is the other worry, right? Today, everybody is living longer. And I still remember when I was in college and school, when my neighbor, unfortunately, was working in PNB Bank, right? He was about to retire and just he died all of a sudden. He was hardly 55, right? I'm talking of 75, 76, right? That time, the life expectancy was very less. And then the entire family went for a toss after his death because nobody planned about all this. He died before retirement, no pension, nothing, and it was really bad. So today, the biggest threat is medical facilities have improved. All of us are going to live for 80, 85 years, right? That is the biggest challenge. So it should not happen that you don't have money and you are living longer, right? That kind of situation should not happen to us. That's where I said retirement planning is very important. So I was just showing you this example here. If you look at this calculation, simple calculation, if you need 75,000 rupees per month, right? And you have want to live roughly, let's say, another 20 years after retirement, right? I'm assuming inflation adjusted return of 1%, right? If I calculate this as the inflation adjusted return, roughly I'll be requiring a corpus of 4.34 crores, right? I'm just giving an example to give you the impact of it, right? So that's where I said, as you come closer to retirement, all these numbers will be clear, right? So this is what I'm saying. Inflation is another worry for us post-retirement. So that's where never put all your money in safe investments. It will not work, right? And what is also equally important is understand your risk appetite. Asset allocation is very important, right? I will take a few minutes here. What is asset allocation? Asset allocation is nothing but putting money in different assets like equity, debt, some amount in real estate, some amount in gold. I need to spread my money because I don't know which asset class will do well. For example, in March, equity crashed by almost 40%. It has now come back again, right? So the issue here is we honestly don't know how much equity will give, how much gold will give. Last year, gold gave excellent performance. Now this year, already it is negative, right? So that is where I said never put all your money in one place. So asset allocation is very, very important. It is nothing but splitting your money in various asset classes. And rebalancing is equally important. When you have a good advisor like Mr. Nikhil, he will be able to tell you what is your asset allocation you need to do, right? How much in equity, how much in debt, based on your goal and risk appetite and all this, and the time horizon also. You will decide that, right? Now, let's say your portfolio return you need is 10%, right? Now, what will happen is you will put your money accordingly. So much in equity, debt, gold, and all those, right? Now, some year, equity will do extremely well. You would have got more than 10%, right? So, in that case, you have to actually book that profit and bring the equity allocation to the old percentage, right? That is what we mean by rebalancing. So, this is at least an annual process. Every year, you should sit with your advisor and try to rebalance your portfolio. That's the only way to achieve your goal. Otherwise, I cannot leave it. Market is unpredictable, right? 1 year it will give me super return, and another year it will give me a super negative return. That is why rebalancing is very important. And the last point is equally important. 3 years before, you should shift your money to debt. Because man, any market fluctuation 3 years before will erode your capital. So these are some of the things which you need to keep in mind. And your advisor will definitely do all these things for you, right? And a simple way to select a fund is, I'll always say this chart, right? Less than 1 year, 1 to 3 years, 3 to 5 years. Where is that I should invest, right? Of course, when you're coming through an advisor, you need not worry about it. You'll be able to do it. And when you're chatting with or having a discussion with your advisor, I think you need to remember these points and understand so that you can have a better discussion with your advisor. So this chart is useful for that. And another thing, man, easiest way to create wealth is do a step-up SIP. Step-up SIP is nothing but increasing it year on year by 10%, right? So for example, somebody is going to give me 10,000 and going to increase by 10% year on year. See the difference in corpus. Without incrementing your SIP, you get 2.5 crores. By incrementing it 10%, your corpus can be almost 7 crores, right? That is important. So always do it, especially when you are starting young, 25 years. Every year you will get increment, right? Same way, increase your SIP by 10%. That is good. These are simple strategies which you can follow. And of course, emergency fund is very important. Ensure that 1 year expenses is always there in liquid investments. That will actually help you. Yeah. And I'll skip this slide. The importance of rebalancing, I've already spoken to you that, right? And somebody who is retiring, right? Let's say who has retired, he has got a corpus now, right? Now, how do I manage it post-retirement? That is another question retirees will be asking me, right? That's where we put this three-basket strategy, right? What is this three-basket strategy? Nothing but first 5 years, let's say I need 50,000 per month, right? Which means 6 lakhs per year. For 5 years, 30 lakhs, right? Now, 30 lakhs, I'll keep it in regular income funds. First 5 years, right? I'll go and put it. I'll not put elsewhere. Wherever it is giving me regular income, I'll go and put that 30 lakhs. The balance money, I'll divide it between bucket 2 and bucket 3, right? What is bucket 2? It will have my balance funds. It will have some long-term debt funds, right? So now, and the last bucket is my equity bucket, third bucket. So there at least 25 to 30% of my money will go into that bucket. I'll not touch it for 10 years. Now, what will happen is, first year, I will exhaust from this bucket one, right? So, I'll have 4 years money, correct? Now, the moment I took 1 year's money out of this, that 1 year money will be filled by the second bucket, because the second bucket would have earned some money for 1 year, right? So, that money I will shift it, right? Same way, if equity has given me some profit, I will shift that money to the second bucket, right? But at no time, I will withdraw money from the first bucket and put it in third bucket. No time I will withdraw money from second bucket and put it in third bucket. That's why I'm giving 10 years for the third bucket. Why? Because market will be volatile. So whenever I'm booking profit, I'll shift it and I will manage that way. So post retirees, you should have your money invested this way. We call this a three bucket strategy. I think that's the best way to do it for the post retirees. And last but not the least, please prepare the will. People always ask this question. I have done nominations. Nomination doesn't mean all the money will go to him. He's just a caretaker, right? Money should go to the legal heirs. So it doesn't mean if I nominate my wife and legal heirs are my brothers and mother, money will go to my brothers and mother also. If you don't write a will, that money can go to all the legal heirs. That's why very important to prepare will. So please do that, right? And ensure that all your investment details, insurance details, is available with your trusted person. Somewhere you should maintain that data. These are the information. Anything happens, this is the contact number, this is the policy number. That data should be readily available, right? Irrespective of whether you are retiring or not, any investments you are doing, please maintain these records, very important. I'll close by saying that what is important you have to remember is always start early. Don't regret if you have not started early. Today itself you start, right? That's where I said invest whatever you can, right? Whatever you can, just keep investing. Do proper asset allocation because you don't know. Don't go and invest in money in some best performing fund, it doesn't work that way. Never do that mistake, right? Please ensure that step up SIP is picked when you opt for SIP. And once in a year, do rebalancing with your advisor and ensure that you have an emergency fund and health insurance policy. Nikhil, I will stop here and we can have a discussion now. Yeah. And we'll take the questions at the end. Yeah. Sure. I hope I have not overshot the time.
No, I think we are very much in. I think we can restrict our discussion if it's needed.
Yeah, no issues. Yeah. Then we can give more time for the Q&A also in case there are questions.
Thank you so much, sir. It's a very informative. I'm sure that all the people who come in for us, the time they are spending for us will be worthwhile. Thank you so much from my side and from all the people who come in to listen to us. So I request all of you to start putting the question in the chat box. So what we will do is that we will take that question and start giving it start discussing also. So keep asking question if you have 1 second. I'll just close that. So I think sharing is done. So now the screen is proper. I think everyone able to see us properly. I think this session on that, I think people will have a confusion that my age is let's say that I'm 50s. And I have only 5 years to retire, and I haven't really started my investment because I was behind all the responsibilities. Because that is what I always hear from people who are, especially Malayalis who are in the Gulf. They would be earning much money, but they had a lot of responsibilities, not only for their own family, but for the entire family circle and society. They are the one who spend the money. So now they are serious because they are at around 48 or 50. And they know that my retirement time has come up. So how do I start investing since I haven't really serious about investing? Now, from onwards, how will I invest? And in 5 years' time, how I kind of invest? So if you can throw some light specific to this kind of category of people.
Yeah. Thanks, Nikhil. Man, honestly, very difficult to answer based on the information what you gave. Because see, two things. One is... I need to understand first what are the assets he's having, right? Say, for example, he might have invested in a house or he might be having some other assets. As you rightly said, people have gone there to fulfill their responsibilities, which is very true. So major portion of his life has gone and fulfilling the responsibilities, right? So now when you want to plan for your retirement, first thing you do is understand what are your assets and what are your liabilities, right? So first understand that. How much you have having assets, what is your liabilities, whether the net is positive. That is one point to understand where you are, right? The second is today, understand how much you will require. For example, if you are planning to come back to India, understand how much you will require monthly to live, right? Understand that amount. Once you know that, as I said, Nikhil will be able to help you what is the corpus you will require, right? Once that corpus, what is required is understood, then we can do the reverse calculation, how much you need to invest to get the corpus, right? But if the amount is too much, don't worry about it. Say, for example, let's say you are getting a corpus of 3 crores, right? And we are saying, boss, you need to invest 2 lakhs or 2.5 lakh a month. You may say, boss, it is just not possible, right? So then the question here is, you have to see whether you can continue your work beyond 55. I mean, that's a logical way to think about it. Because if I don't have money, because the only other logical way is I have to postpone my retirement. Now, if you come and tell me there, because my office will ensure that I leave by 55, then you see how your professional qualification can help you to do consultancy work or something else, right? So that is where I said, unless we get all these details, it is very difficult to give a clear-cut answer. So we need to find this. So the basic thing is understand your assets, understand your liabilities, and then see how much you require monthly to manage your lifestyle, and then see whether you can create the corpus. If you are able to create the corpus within that period, nothing to worry. if you are not able to create the corpus bus, there is no other choice than to continue your work, right? I think that is what will be the solution I can suggest, given the data available to
me. I think this kind of category we have a lot, and
yeah,
because most of the time there is a immense reasons they would have not thought about retirement as a specific thing, because they will be thinking about their kids will be there to support and everything. So
never do that. Never do that. And this reminds me, Nikhil, I thought about myself. See, I have invested in 2 houses now, right? Now the question is, when I'm falling short of my corpus, now my thought is, I'll sell one house and then take that money and include in my corpus, right? That's where I said we need to look at all these details, right?
Okay.
So today I can obviously sell another house because I need only one house to live.
Okay.
So I'll try to sell the house which gives me the maximum money, and I don't mind going and staying in another house where it is comfortable living for me, right? Okay. So all these decisions will come into play when you are saying it actually.
Okay. So, what about, because even in our case, especially in Kerala, we have a lot of people with land and gold sitting on it. So, how do we plan? Is it that we kind of suggest them to do a rental, giving for rental, or I know this is specific to individuals, but how important is that we are keeping the assets in liquid forms?
Post retirement, your assets should be in the most liquid form.
Okay.
Pre-retirement, it is still okay, right? Post retirement, you don't know what kind of emergency you will face, right? It could be a health issue, it could be anything else, right? So 100% it should be in most liquid. We always say SLR, right?
Uh-huh.
Safety, liquidity, and finally comes the return, right? So my assets should be safe.
Yes,
post retirement, I'm saying it should be liquid, and then the last factor is my return, right? So always remember this SLR for retirement, post-retirement, right? So, man, if you have land, everything, boss, just sell it. Unless you want to own some piece of land or give it to your children, absolutely, man, no point in holding on. People might question this, right? Land has given great return. All this is fine. The question is, are you in a position to maintain it post-retirement? It may not be possible, right? And, I can share a couple of instances which happened in Bangalore. One of my relatives had to go through this. They had a house in a prime property, right? Worth crores of rupees. Three and a half crores or something. All these goons, they just came to our house early morning. They just threatened with a knife and said, now you sell it to us at this price, right? 1 crore or something. A three and a half crore worth property. They said, you sell it to us. You are signing this agreement. 1 crore. We'll give you cash and you are not opening your mouth, right? Why should I get into all this?
Yeah.
There is no need, right? And especially that's why I said, if your property is in prime place, fetching lot of money, because lot of people will be eyeing for it. And my own brother, when he was trying to sell in Coritur in Chennai, he got lot of calls from the politicians and who not. He was so afraid, he said, boss, whatever price comes, let me first dispose it off. So that's where all this land and all, you have lot of problems associated. So earlier the better, you sell it and keep it in liquid. Nobody will disturb you, right?
Okay.
So that's the best thing to do. Yeah.
And I think ensure that all the documentation and will, everything is in place.
Exactly. Yeah. Very, very important. Yeah. And never go by nominee alone. Yeah. Nominee is only a caretaker of the money.
Yeah, I think that is something which we were always discussing. And now in our society, writing will is something that they take it as at the last option, not that early stage.
This reminds me, actually, one of my one of our investor in this kind of program, he asked me that after the meeting. He came and asked me, sir, what you said is right, I agree, but I have a problem. I said, what is the problem? He says, the moment I start sitting for the will, I feel something will happen to me.
That is
psychological.
That is another thing.
Yeah. Then I told him, boss, will you not take a life insurance policy? Will you say that if I take a life insurance policy, something will happen to me? You don't say that, right? That's the way I need to look at will also. right? Not necessarily if I start writing, something will happen. The problem is we are actually preventing our family members to have less problems post our demise, right? Because that problem will be much more to them. That is where we say, because you write a will, then money will go to whomever you want it. Otherwise, well, government will decide who will,
that is important thing.
Yeah, otherwise government will decide whom the money should go.
Yeah.
And it is your hard-earned money, you should be in a position to give to whomever you want it.
True. Thank you. And I think, you know, this is just another experience which I was talking to someone. And this person, not only problem with the will, but he has a problem with taking insurance, life insurance. He thinks that I am healthy, I am blessed one. Then taking insurance is something against that thought process.
Hey, that is, I mean, in fact, I jokingly used to say, imagine you go to an astrologer, right? And the astrologer tells you, but I'm going to live till 80.
Yeah.
Will I believe that and stop taking my insurance policy? Then obviously not, right? Because astrologer will tomorrow say, "Boss, your birth time you didn't give me correctly. That's why this error has happened." But the problem is for my dependents, right? I mean, my thought process can be fine. What I'm saying is, are you taking care of your dependents?
Yeah.
So long as I'm alive, my thought process is okay. But what happens when I'm not alive? Who is going to suffer?
I
honestly tell, the only guys who don't require life insurance is who have a lot of money. For example, Mukesh Ambani need not take life insurance policy, correct?
Yeah, I think, right? you never know if the balance sheet has more debt and this one in future. Like
at least that is okay, right? I mean, honestly, I have to see that if the debt is there, then everything will go. For example, we have this cafe coffee day, right?
Yeah.
That kind of incident, you are absolutely right on that.
Yeah.
But what I am trying to say here is, if you have enough wealth, then you don't require a life insurance.
Yeah.
That's where we say, beyond 60, you don't require a life insurance if you have created wealth.
Yeah, probably.
But if you have not created wealth, then obviously even beyond 60, you have to continue your life insurance policy, because at least that will give some money to your family members.
Thank you. I think, you know, I'm just getting into the chat room, because in case if you are not covering them, so in between, if I have time, I will ask the questions which I have.
Yeah, sure.
Let us, because already I think around seven, eight questions are there. So let us take that also. So I think the first question, what will be the right investment for a 40-year person who is looking for a regular pension from 55? So the person is 40. He is looking for a regular income post 55.
Nikhil, first thing what you should do here is, as I told you, understand what is the corpus he requires and what is the expenses he requires. You need to do that calculation first, right? And now I have an age of 40 to 55. So I have a 15-year period, right? Now in this 15-year period, the first 10 years, 40 to 50, maybe I can have a higher allocation to equity, right? And from 50 till 55, obviously I have to move my money to the debt portion, right? So that is the kind of calculation we need to do. And before that, we need to understand from him, what is his monthly pension, what he is looking at. Once we are clear about it, then we can do this calculation and tell him what is that we can do. How do I build that portfolio? I think that is the exercise you have to do one-on-one with them.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. I hope I answered his question. Yeah.
Naveen, okay. I'll just probe another thing. So normally when we have this kind of a situation, we have a lot of, advertisement, like specifically about pension product. And we have products in mutual fund fraternity also. So what is the kind of right allocation we can give it for this kind of pension product and for the specific equity or debt products?
See, honestly, if you say until the age of 55, I'm not looking at any pension products at all, right? For the simple reason, the returns are too minimal. Wherever there is a guaranteed amount, if you go and look at the return, it will be 5.5, not more than that today.
Yeah. Right? I was specifically asking for that secured product, because we have
exactly
emotional attachment towards the word secured.
Secure, yeah. Because you are exactly right. Yeah. the moment I say secured, boss, please understand your return is going to be 5.25, 5.5. Nothing more than that, right? And they may say, I will give you till life and all those things. Absolutely don't even look at it, right? I will say you should look at these products probably after 70.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because you are going to live for a lesser period beyond 70, and there you need to have some regular income, right? So beyond 70, you can probably do some allocation to that. But till 70, I feel you should work with mutual fund products, which is a combination of debt and equity. And based on your requirement, we can do this ratio. Like, for example, I told for that 40 to 55, up to 50, you can have a higher allocation to equity. But after 50, I have to reduce the equity portion and have debt and see how I can get that corpus, right? Mm-hmm. And then we need to understand all those assets. That's where I said, answer is not in one sentence or two sentence. We need to get all this information and then build a portfolio, and then we'll be able to give the right answer.
Yeah.
But overall, I said, these are the things which he has to tell. What are his assets, liabilities, then what is the corpus he requires, how much I should invest in equity today, how much is able to save, right? All these are important points which we need to understand. Yeah.
Okay. I think there is another question comes. Is
yeah.
Same line, pension policies, which is kind of offered by LIC and SBI. We don't have to really mention about the companies, but I think the same answer goes with...
The returns are very low. I mean, another mistake what we should not do is, when interest rate regime is very low, never go for this annuity products.
Mm-hmm.
Because today you will get very low interest. If tomorrow, let's say my interest regime goes to 7.5-8%, it makes a lot of sense that time to go and buy some annuity products. When the interest rates are very low, delay your annuity purchase.
Okay.
Because you will get this 5.5% for your entire life.
Mm-hmm.
Correct? So there is no point in locking your money at such low interest for a longer period.
Mm-hmm.
So instead, manage it for 2-3 years till the rates go up. And once the rates reaches a good level, I mean, just to give an example, I remember in 1998, one of my advisors suggested one retirement LIC pension, Dhan Raksha or something. I even forgot the name. It was giving 10.25% return that time. Yeah, 98, I am saying, right? Yeah. Very high interest rate. Today, my last installment of 10,000 is going to come next year, next March, right? That is my last installment till the age of 58. Now, from 59, my pension will start. You will not believe it is 10,000 into, let's say, now 22 years I have put, right? 2,20,000 is my investment.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I am going to get 7,000 rupees per month for the next 15 years.
Mm-hmm.
Right, you can see 84 into 15, right? So my investment is 2 lakhs, but I'm going to get some 10 lakhs plus, right? So the yield works out to be 10.25. Those things are not available today.
Yeah.
My yield is 5.25, 5.5 maximum, right? So don't go by those calculations and get attracted towards it. Actual, what is the return, you calculate that. That, Nikhil, you can help them in understanding what is the return which is coming. And then you take a call. Because recently somebody came and asked me, sir, I've got a 2 crore corpus. I want to invest 60 lakhs in this annuity. It is giving me this much. Then I calculated and showed him. Boss, this is the return you are getting, 5.25. Do you want to go and lock it? When my low duration fund in a mutual fund will give me more return than that. Plus, it gives you better tax benefits.
Yeah, this lock-in is the biggest problem. Yeah, I think.
Lock-in is the biggest period. For 25 years, 30 years, you are locking at that low interest. I mean, I will never suggest. Wait for the rates to go up. And when you get a 7.5-8% kind of return, it makes a lot of sense to go and buy an annuity product that time.
Okay. And there is another question come from Bandhu.
Yeah.
So the question is that suggest good scheme for children education with a time horizon of 15 to 20 years.
I mean, honestly, I will say a good diversified equity fund is the solution for this.
Okay.
15 to 20 years, a good equity diversified fund will meet your requirement, right? That is my suggestion, and apply those basic factors, right? 3 years before, try to move that money. That's where having a good advisor is very important. If you follow these basic principles, boss, you will create wealth for the education goal also.
I think one issue we have is that we don't really see that what is that goal amount. And we kind of, I think... whenever we reach that goal amount, we have to kind of move to debt fund. But that is something we think that another 2 years are there, another 3 years are there. Why I need to satisfy with 5%?
No, seriously, man, I still remember one of the meetings when I went there. I think this was some 2017 or 16. I don't remember the period. The one lady came and said, "Sir, I was saving for my daughter's marriage. I've got whatever amount I required, it has come. And should I continue?" I said, "Don't do it. Immediately withdraw and keep it." She said, no. What will happen in the next 1 year? Nothing will happen. And equity has given excellent return, especially that 16-17 period, right? And she said, "I will continue." I said, "I leave it to you. You asked me a question, I have answered you. Now it is your decision." I mean, believe me, the next 1 year, market started losing and I was only thinking about her. Mm-hmm. I mean, whether she really did what I said or she followed what she wanted to do.
Yeah.
Right? That is where, boss, don't lose your hard-earned money just for market fluctuations, right? When you have achieved your goal, just play it safe.
Okay.
Don't even worry what is the return you would have lost it. That is not the important, right? What is important is you have achieved your goal. And then you should retain that, right? That is more important. Don't worry, market would have gone up. I mean, I might have been proved wrong also, right? Market could have gone up from there. Anything is a possibility. But, don't regret about it. Achieving your goal is more important.
Yeah.
What I didn't get, I should not worry about it.
No, I think it's all about that. We have that mentality, right? Winning and losing. And,
exactly. Yeah. And, we need to be men. Majority of the investments go wrong for the simple reason because of our behavior only.
Yeah.
It is not because of market, not for anything else. It is how we behave is creating the problem for us.
Yeah. I think, you know, most of the time after we sell also, we track the price of that particular stock or...
We shouldn't do that. We should never do it. Because some of the decisions will go wrong. Let's be clear, right? Life also, so many decisions go wrong, correct? But we don't regret about it, right? Today we are happy. All of us are happy. Like my father wanted me to be engineer because both my brothers were engineers, right? But somehow I didn't fit into it, right? But today I don't regret, man. I am as happy as my brothers are, right? So some decisions will not go as you wanted, Bhagan. Like, we have to accept it. Be it investment, be it life. I mean, there is an amount of luck in investment. I always used to say this, right? I mean, just to share with our investors here. I mean, we all know Bill Gates, right? We know how he is. But what is beyond that, there is a story. What is that story? He studied in a school which had a computer. And he was lucky to study in such a school during his times. No other school had a computer. So he was the first mover's advantage, right? Only 300 children were there in the school. And he was one among that school. And only that school had a computer. So these guys were able to use that and gain a higher knowledge, right? And why I'm saying luck is coming here is, another friend of his was equally brilliant, right? Unfortunately, all the three of them, right, Paul and Gates and one more, this guy, Edward or somebody, Ivan. Right, all the three guys were supposed to start this Microsoft company. Right, unfortunately, this guy, the third guy, in the school itself, he went for a mountaineering expedition and he died in that. Such a brilliant guy. Why I'm saying is, sometimes luck plays a factor in your life as well as investment. So, there is an element of luck. We need to believe in that. That's where I said, boss, we need to plan in a year on year, right? We need to, that's where I said rebalancing is very important. Some years will be very lucky, some years will be bad. So that's where we need to keep rebalancing our portfolio.
Okay. And you know, I think this is just to go a little away from investment. Most of the time, post-retirement, what people can do, because especially in Kerala, we have a lot of people from abroad, and they, especially Middle East, they don't settle there, they will come back here. So how do they plan their post retirement in terms of not only for the finance but from the outside finance, how they should plan their life? They should do something, or they should your experience, if you can throw something.
Honestly, if you look at being active post retirement is very important, right? very, very important, because if you are not active, you are getting into health troubles. So minimum 1 to 2 hours of exercise is very important. Second is, understand what is that you are good at, right? It may be technical, it could be anything else. See how you can contribute it back to the society, right? Maybe if you feel that, I mean, I can go and work in an ashram, or I can go and work in an old age home, I can spend some time there. Because how you spend your time, that 7 or 8 hours, is very important. That's where, if you are professionally qualified, see whether you can work as a consultant. Not from the money perspective, I'm saying. What will help you is, you are actually active, that will keep you healthy, right? So you need to understand what is it you are good at, whether you can have another career post-retirement, right? Not purely from a point of money, purely from giving that satisfaction, because now I don't require money, I am working because of my interest, right? So that is what you should try to find out, right? What is your area of interest? It could be anything. It could be your own profession, or it could be something else. I mean, some of them will say, because I started learning music and I'm going and playing it, right? I mean, recently I got to know about a guy who's from IIT, and he's also a CEO. You will be surprised, this guy is doing a music program also, right? What I'm saying is, each of us might have diverse talents, and probably we're not using all those talents because of our pre-scheduled or busy schedule, right? But post-retirement, you have the entire time with you, right? So probably you identify and engage in some activity. One is definitely your health is a priority. So you need to give 1 or 2 hours for your health, right? Morning yoga or exercise, whatever you are comfortable with, you have to do 1 or 2 hours. Because health is the biggest cost, expenses which is going to come to you if you don't take care of it. So my first thing is health I have to focus on. Second is definitely I can engage usefully, either whatever you like to do. I think these two, if you are able to do it, honestly, man, I have already thought what I should do once I retire. Already the plan is in place, right? So only thing is I have to go and execute it. So that kind of clarity we should get at least 2 or 3 years before we retire.
Okay, thank you. I think this is people like you only can say that, because I think you are at the verge of doing retirement.
Exactly, yeah. Very true.
I think the first thing is at health, and the next is at, I think, do the things which you love, not for, exactly, the, for yourself kind of thing.
Right? Yeah, yeah.
And I think there is another question. One person asked that he's 30 years old and already invested in Kotak, Standard, Multicap, and Axis Exclusive. And will this fund help him to create a retirement fund?
Yeah. See, honestly, never do that mistake of investing in the best fund, right? I'm not saying ki, but this is the two funds you should invest. The point is, you are saying this is giving this much best return. That is where I'm asking. Otherwise, I don't have anything against both these funds, right? Because people make that mistake. For example, if I had to tell 2017-18, everybody was investing in mid-cap because mid-cap gave the best return. Now from 2017 till date, everybody is negative or just about positive. So never go and select a fund based on the performance. That is point number one, I will say, right? And by this, I'm not demeaning both the funds. Don't take me otherwise, right? So my question here is, yes, you should invest in equity when you have time. That is principle number one, right? Which equity fund, which sector? See a 10-year history. Don't look at the recent performance, right? Because recent, somebody will do well, somebody will not do well. Over a 10-year period, if he has given a decent return, then go and invest in that fund. So the same two funds which you are talking also, go and see their 10-year return. If you are happy with their 10-year performance, this is why I'm saying 10 years is, it would have seen one up and one down cycle. So after that also, they have given a decent return over a 10-year period, but definitely go and invest in that fund. Absolutely no problem with that.
Okay. I think we have this tendency to go back to money control and value research. And
exactly. That is the biggest problem. Right? Today, if you ask, people will invest in gold and pharma funds.
Yeah,
why? Because they are giving the, they are giving the best return.
Everyone, right, is becoming a pharma analyst now.
Exactly. Because of COVID, now everybody says all pharma. So these companies have been in existence for so long. How is that 1 year everything will change, right? So that is where, don't go to this website, see the performance and put your money. That's the biggest mistake. I mean, I can say from my experience, whichever is the best fund this year will not even be in the list next year. So you'll be shocked. you will say, "Boss, I thought this is the best performing. I put my money." And the second factor we should always remember is have a decent expectation. Don't expect 15%, 20% in from equity in the coming days, boss. Next to impossible. When my bank is giving me 5 to 6%, the maximum equity can give you is 10%. So I need to be happy even if I get 10%. That is the reality. So be realistic in your expectation. Don't think that an equity will give me 15 or 20. You can't expect that kind of return in the present circumstances. Overall economy is down. Markets are, somehow we are lucky that markets is still at 12,000. Yeah, right?
Market is not going
along. Yeah, it has not gone down. So I should feel lucky about it. Right. So from here, to expect 15% return is not realistic. Right. So I need to do all the calculation expecting 10 to 12% kind of return. That is what will be realistic.
Thank you. Thank you. I think, you know, we need to again do that calculation and see that how much time is there. Okay. And another question is that, you know, is it good to invest in LIC Jeevan Anand scheme or invest in amount in mutual funds? So comparison between insurance and so.
Yeah, that's what I said. All the, I mean, honestly, don't mix insurance with return, right? These two things, I need to keep it separately. Insurance, only a term insurance policy is good enough for me, right? Something happens to me, I should take care. Now, all these are pension policies. If it is there, calculate what we call it as IRR, right? We say the internal rate of return. If you calculate that, after that, you decide. If it is anything around 7.5, boss, go and put your money. I'll be the last person to stop you. If your IRR works out to be 7.5 or 8, please go and put your money. Absolutely, I don't have any issues. Right, but if it is 5.25, then you should ask that question. Yeah, if I keep it in FD itself, it will give me that 5.5%. Why should I go and lock in that money for 25 years? FD, at least if rates go up tomorrow, I'll get that high rate. Now here I'm locking that interest for a lifelong. So I will never do that. I mean, first thing is I'll ask you to check the IRR. Please check the IRR. That is my answer.
Yeah, we don't have that culture of going for IRR. Instead, we want to see the printed money. Don't do that.
Because IRR is what actually you are going to get it, right? Yeah. So once you see that, then you decide.
Yeah. And I think there is it's a really good discussion. Next question. It's like he has an insurance from the office. So is it good to have a different health insurance scheme or now itself or take a health insurance post retirement?
Great question. I mean, I should have touched this point. I didn't touch it. Thanks for asking this question. Very, very important to take it immediately. Very, very important to take it immediately. Two reasons, right? First reason, if your office asks you to leave tomorrow, you will not have any coverage, right? Don't tell me my office will not ask me to leave. Yeah, that's not the answer, correct? I mean, I have to assume if something happens, what is the protection I have, right? If nothing happens, so you are not going to lose anything, right? So please take the policy immediately. That is point number one, right? The second advantage is when you are young, your premium will be less. If you are going to wait after 60 and unfortunately you get some health issues, the premium will simply shoot up. And the coverage they will give, they will put a lot of restriction. First 3 years, existing disease are not covered. All those things will come. So never wait for it. Immediately go and take an additional policy. And today's environment, you need to have at least a 25 lakh policy minimum.
Yeah.
All your 2 lakh, 3 lakh, 5 lakh doesn't work at all. Minimum, I'm saying 25. If you can do 50 lakhs, please go ahead and do it.
Yeah.
If the premium is not much for you, boss, definitely worth taking a 50 lakh policy today. Yeah. Because especially after all these COVID things, every person bill is 25 lakhs, 30 lakhs, 35 lakhs. I mean, that's where I said the biggest expense post-retirement is your health. So I need to have a 50 lakh policy if possible. If not, a minimum 25 lakhs, nothing like less than that.
Thank you. I think this is something which is we all think that I have insurance.
Correct.
And I don't see that I have any disease coming up. So a lot of...
Definitely no. Nothing, man.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Don't be in for a shock later, right? So better avoid it.
Yeah, I think another question is that how can I plan my investment based on 5 years, 10 years, 15 years plan like that?
So as I showed you that chart, I don't mind showing it again, that periods are given, right? So you can accordingly take your call, right? You for check. Example, just give me a minute. This is the way I need to plan it, right? If it is a 5-year horizon, I can have some allocation to the balance funds, right? If it is less than 5 years, my money should go to a debt. If it is more than 6 years, I can invest in a large cap fund, right? That's the way I need to plan it. So your major part of the money will go there. And at any point of time, 20% of your money should be in cash or debt, because market will give you opportunities, right? So that time you should have money. So always keep 20-25% in debt, so that you'll be able to do this switch to equity or debt as the case may be. Yeah, I think that's the way we need to go about it. Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks. Okay. Another question is that he's 32 years old and planning for a retirement in 7 years. Currently investing through SIP 2.5 lakhs in various assets, gold 2% allocation, then equity 75% allocation, debt 21% of allocation. Is it a right track for him? So that's a question.
Perfect. I think whoever has suggested him is bang on. Right, whoever has suggested him has done the right thing, no doubt about it. Now, what is important is how much that 2.5 lakhs will work out in 7 years, whether that corpus, because if I heard you right, 39 years he wants to retire or something, he said?
7 years' time. So that means 39. Yeah. Now 32, he is looking for
7 years' time.
7 years.
Right. Time. Boss, it's very risky to retire at 39, honestly, man, unless you have created that kind of wealth or you have that kind of wealth, right? And again, I don't know what is that you are going to do after 39. If already you have clear-cut plans of doing something which you already have in mind, and then it's fine. So I need to understand all that. Otherwise, man, what you have done is perfectly right. That 72% allocation, all those are absolutely the right thing you have done. So no second thoughts on it. Only thing is, was whether that corpus is enough for you. I'm just imagining 39 to, let's say, 80. Which means 41 years, will that cover? I mean, corpus will be sufficient? Unless you are clear what is that you are going to do after 39, right? Some of them might be very clear. This is what I intend to do. For that, this is the money I needed. That money is already there. Then no problem at all. Yeah. Otherwise, the asset allocation is bang on. Whoever has suggested or if you have done on your own, hats off to you. Absolutely, you have got it right.
Okay. Thank you. I think this is, I had this in mind, but since the questions came up, I didn't ask. So this the FIRE movement, this financial independence and retire early, and this financial freedom, all this movement is going on these days. So what is your suggestion for a, like you already mentioned that a person at 40 is retiring and what they do. So can you touch on something in 2 minutes? And I think the kind of audience are there here.
Yeah. See, honestly, if I had to take a easiest example, I can take all our cricketers, right? They don't have a shelf life beyond 40, correct? And some of them will retire even much before that. If I take a Suresh Raina, probably he has retired at 34. So the question is, all the actors these days are acting even beyond 50, but the sports people, especially beyond 40, you are not there, right? You don't get an opportunity. So the question is, you need to create that corpus. Luckily for them, they earn so much in those 5-10 years. Each of them are worth 100, 200 crores, if not more. Correct? So are we in a position? And of course, their lifestyle is different. So for them, 100, 200 crores is required. We might have a very simple lifestyle, so we don't require 100 crores, right? Maybe I'll be happy with a 15 or a 20 crores probably, right? When I'm retiring. So the first important thing is, do you have that corpus? Imagine you are not doing anything after 40. I'm just assuming that condition, you are not doing anything after 40, right? So do you have the corpus to manage for the next 40 years? So that is the first point, right? The second aspect is, imagine you are doing something, which means if there is not going to be a regular income in that activity, whatever you're going to do, how long you'll be able to sustain? So for that, whether you have created the corpus, I think these two things will help you to decide whether you have got the financial freedom to do what you want, right? If you have that financial freedom at 40 itself, boss, please go ahead and enjoy your life here. Nothing can be more happier than that, right? So honestly, if somebody is able to take that call to retire at 39, I mean, hats off to him, seriously. I mean, you are able to do what you want. I mean, something really appreciable. We are all working because we couldn't do what we want, right? So we are planning only post-retirement to do what we want to do. So, I mean, financial freedom is what will decide retirement here, honestly. Your financial freedom will determine the date of retirement. When I say retirement, retirement is not another life. It is exactly what you want to do. You are getting time to do what you want to do.
Yeah.
Otherwise, till then, you'll be doing what others want you to do. That's it.
Yeah, thanks. Okay, we are already close to 12 o'clock, but we have few more questions.
Yeah, we can take it. If it is not affecting the investors, if they can stay alone for some more time, we can take it. Yeah, no issues.
We'll just quickly go through. So another person is that saying that, same answer, 31 years now, 41st year, he want to retire, 10 years time to invest. So I think the same thing which you have mentioned.
Yeah.
We can.
Sir, you can need to help all of them in those online calculations, Nikhil.
Sujit.
Yeah. Actually, I'm 36 years old, sir, and working for an IT company. Okay.
Okay.
இப்ப பாத்தீங்கன்னா நினைச்சீங்களா நான் சென்னை தான் சோ தமிழ் தமிழ்ல பேசலாம் நினைக்கிறேன்
கண்டிப்பா கண்டிப்பா பேசலாம்
சோ இப்ப பாத்தீங்கன்னா நினைச்சீங்களா எனக்கு எவ்வளவு நாள் ஒர்க் இருக்கும் எனக்கு தெரியாது எக்ஸாக்டா இப்ப நீங்க சொன்ன மாதிரி 40 இயர்ஸ் நான் பிளான் பண்ணலாம் பட் நாளைக்கே ஒரு பிங்க் ஸ்லிப் கொடுத்தாங்கன்னு நினைச்சீங்கன்னா ரொம்ப கஷ்டம் சோ அப்படி பாத்தீங்கன்னா நினைச்சீங்களா நான் எல்லாம் எப்படி பண்ணலாம் இப்ப இன்னொரு இது பாத்தீங்கன்னா நீங்க சொன்னீங்க லேண்ட் அசட் லேண்ட் என்னால இப்ப வாங்க முடியல சென்னையிலயும் சரி ஊர்லயும் சரி சோ ஆன்சஸ்டர்ஸ் லேண்ட் எல்லாம் ஆன்சஸ்டர்ஸ் லேண்ட் எல்லாம் கொஞ்சம் வந்திருக்கு அது தெய்வ புண்ணியத்துல அப்படியே இருக்கும் பாத்தீங்கன்னா பிளஸ் வைஃப் கிட்ட இருந்து கொஞ்சம் கோல்டு வந்துருந்துச்சு டவுரியா வாங்கல பட் அவங்க கிஃப்டா கொடுத்தாங்க அதுல பாத்தீங்கன்னா நான் ஒரு 50% எடுத்துட்டேன் சோ கேஷா வச்சுக்கிட்டு ஈக்விட்டியில போட ஆரம்பிச்சிருக்கேன் ஒரு 2-3 இயர்ஸா கொஞ்சம் நல்லா ஒரு மெஜாரிட்டி இதா போயிட்டு இருக்கு ரிட்டர்ன்ஸ் வந்துட்டு இருக்கு பிளஸ் கொஞ்சம் எஃப்டியா நான் போட்டு வச்சிருக்கேன் சோ மந்த்லி இன்கம் வரும் கொஞ்சம் எஃப்டியில போடுவேன் கொஞ்சம் முக்கவாசி பாத்தீங்கன்னா இப்ப ஈக்விட்டியில தான் போயிட்டு இருக்கு சோ இயர்லி ரிட்டர்ன் இவ்வளவு நீங்க சொன்ன மாதிரி ஒரு 15% வந்துச்சுன்னா ஒரு பாசிவ் இன்கம் மாதிரி பாத்துட்டு இருக்கேன் வந்துச்சுன்னா ஓகே லார்ஜர் ஃபண்ட்ல தான் போடுறேன் நல்ல கம்பெனி ரிலையன்ஸ் அந்த மாதிரி தான் போட்டு இருக்கேன் சோ வந்துச்சுன்னா பெட்டர் இல்லாட்டி கொஞ்சம் 1 year லாங் டேர்மாவும் அப்படியே சேஞ்ச் பண்ணிடுவேன் கொஞ்சம் ப்ராஃபிட் வந்துச்சுன்னா அப்படியே ரிவர்ட் பண்ணிட்டு கொஞ்சம் அப்படியே ஒரு இது மாத்திக்கிட்டே இருக்கேன் ஏன்னா மிட் கேப் அந்த மாதிரி இதெல்லாம் ஃபண்ட்ல போடுறதுக்கு எனக்கு அவ்வளவு இது இல்லை ஏன்னா இருக்கிற கேபிட்டல் கெயினை வந்து அப்படியே ப்ரொடெக்ட் பண்ணணும்னு பாக்குறேன் ஸோ நீங்க எப்படி சஜஸ்ட் பண்ணுவீங்க ஒரு ஐடி ப்ரொஃபஷனல் பாத்தீங்கன்னா இப்ப சென்னையில இருக்கிறதால என்னோட எக்ஸ்பென்ஸ் வந்து ஜாஸ்தி ரெண்டெல்லாம் இருக்கேன் ஸோ அந்த இதுல இருக்கு இப்ப எனக்கு ஊர்ல இருந்துச்சுன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்க எனக்கு ரெண்டல் இல்ல ஒரு மந்த்லி எக்ஸ்பென்ஸ் வந்து 8000 இருந்துச்சுனாவே எனக்கு பணக்காரம் ரொம்ப பணக்காரம் மாதிரி இருந்துக்கலாம் மெடிக்கல் எக்ஸ்பென்சஸ் தவிர பாத்தீங்கன்னா சோ இப்ப பாத்தீங்கன்னா இங்க ஒரு 25,000 கிடைச்சாலும் அப்படியே போயிடுது 25,000 மந்த்லி எக்ஸ்பென்சஸ்க்கு போயிடும் சோ அப்ப எப்படி நம்ம பிளான் பண்ணலாம் ஒரு ஐடி ப்ரொஃபஷனல் வழியா ஜாப் வந்து கொஞ்சம் இப்பதுக்கு வர சேலரி வச்சு ஓகே சூப்பரா போகும் பட் கொஞ்சம் ஒரு எவ்வளவு வருஷத்துக்கு வரும் தெரியல ஏன்னா என் கலீக்ஸ் எல்லாம் கொஞ்சம் பேர் அப்படியே பெஞ்சுக்கு போனாங்க அப்படியே தூக்கிட்டாங்க பெஞ்ச் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி அதான் சோ எப்படி பிளான் பண்ணலாம்னு சொல்றீங்க
So that's what I had a doubt before answering in Tamil because I know the language. It shouldn't happen. Others are
Even for me, I can understand, but I think
Actually, my mother tongue is Marathi, but having brought up in Chennai, I have learnt Tamil. So that's how it is. I mean, I have my major life is in Chennai. 25 years I spent in Chennai. I was born in Kumbakonam and then moved to Chennai in 64, and since almost till 89, I was in. 86, I should say, I was in Chennai. Then 86, I went to Trichy, and from there, I have been going all around the country, and that's how it is. Yeah, coming back to the point, I observed a couple of things. Correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you said you are investing. I'm assuming you're investing directly in the market, right?
Yeah, you could say.
Yeah, if it is doing that, be careful. Don't just go by saying that it is a large cap stock or a good company, because all these things can go for a toss. So be careful. Second, what is more important is, are you doing like a trading? That is what I'm more worried, right? because if you're doing like a trading, yeah. Why I'm saying is, because all said and done, since you are now 36 or something, please also focus on your career. When I say career, what I mean is improve your technical qualification. If you can do something, that will give you more return than your investment. Let me be honest with you. You are technically qualified. You are adding additional qualification. You can always be sold in the market. So your own PE is more important. After that, only the market PE will come. First, ask yourself, what is your PE? Your PE has to be very high. That will give you more income, and that more income you can invest. So I will say, first, you focus on gaining your technical knowledge, be it some other course or whatever you feel. That is, again, as a advice I am giving, nothing more, right? The second is, be very, very careful you are investing in market directly. Because we will say that it is a large cap fund, right? I'm investing in big companies. I mean, Reliance have been at 900 rupees for the last 3 years. Only in the last 3-4 months, it has gone to 2000 rupees, right? Even be a big company, it might go through that. You see Bharti Airtel, so many things are there, right? So unless you have the knowledge about the companies, why I'm saying is, you are busy in your work, right? How much analysis you are able to do about the companies, I am not sure. So for me, if you ask me, if you have, let's say, 5 lakhs or 10 lakhs, I'm just giving an example, right? Out of which you are investing 1 lakh direct equity, I'm fine with it. But your major portion should go through the mutual funds. I'm not saying mutual fund because I'm working in mutual fund. Please don't take it that way. I'm saying your focus should be on your job now. And whether you are technically qualified to analyze all these companies. I mean, I doubt whether you can do it. If you say I can do it, well, then you go ahead and do what you are doing. Otherwise, my honest answer will be, don't just say that I'm investing only in large companies. It will give me decent return. And you also mentioned that last 2-3 years has been good. Boss, you may be lucky. Please understand that. You may be lucky. So don't assume that I am doing all the things right. Right? Because I'll tell you, man, I invested in TVS Motor when it was 34 rupees, correct? And I sold it at 350. After that, it went to 700, right? Now you tell me whether I was lucky, I was not lucky. Absolutely, I was not checking any information. I was lucky, that's it. That's where I said luck plays an important role in investment. And what we do is, when we are lucky, we consider that I'm doing the right things, right? Because why, again, you are making some basic mistakes is, you said 50% of my gold I have cashed and I am investing that money in equity, right? Encashing gold and investing in equity is fine. But are you investing directly? Tomorrow something happens. Your portfolio falls by 30, 40% or 50%. Boss, then you will be in for a rude shock. That's where I said, boss, at least mutual funds will be in a better position. Somebody is managing your money. And your focus should be on your career, right? Improve your qualifications in that line. Understand where is the demand in IT sector today, which tools will help you to be able to be sold in the market. I think at your age, that is what the first focus is. Ensure that you are able to increase your income first. Then you can peacefully invest through all these mutual funds and you can concentrate in your work. That will be my personal advice. Yeah. And land, I'm fully agreeing with you. Keep it for your daughter's marriage or something. Hold on to the land unless you find there is other reasons to sell it. Otherwise, I agree with you on the land part of it. It just ensure that it is safer. Normally, I still remember when Tambram we had a land, right? When my father expired, I got it. First thing I did was to go and sell it. Because I don't know anybody will encroach it or not. All those things are there. Just take care of that. If you feel that it is safe, nobody will encroach it, continue. Absolutely no problem with the land. Just before the marriage or something, but give enough time. Because it's not easy to sell real estate easily. So immediately you may not find a buyer. So give sufficient time. If you are planning to get your daughter married, at least 2 years before, try to sell the property so that you have time. Otherwise, you will go and make a distressed sale, right? So avoid all this. You should be good enough. My honest advice is, first focus on your job, improve your qualifications, add more technical skills, and leave the investments to the mutual funds part of it. Select a good advisor and give the money to manage.
Okay.
I hope Sujit, I answered your question.
Thanks a lot.
Don't take me otherwise. தப்பா எடுத்துக்காதீங்க.
இல்ல 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 அப்படி எல்லாம் எடுத்துக்க மாட்டேன். எல்லாமே பாசிட்டிவ் தான்.
Right. Thanks a lot, Sujit. Thank you.
Thanks you for asking that question. Okay. There are plenty of questions. I just quickly run through. I think there are questions that could you just quickly explain that top up SIP, that step up
SIP? Yeah. What is step up SIP? See, for example, let's say I'm starting an SIP of 5,000 rupees now, right? After 1 year, it will become 5,500 because I have said the top up is 10%, right? I can give an amount or I can give it in percentage. Better to give in percentage, right? So my second year SIP, it will start with 5,500. Now the third year will be 10% of 5,500, which is another 550. So it becomes 6,050, right? So that way, when you start investing, what will happen is your capital will grow. So that's where I said the two things always do it. Don't put an end date to your SIP. You can always stop SIP whenever you want it. So it should be a perpetual SIP, right? And second is, it should be a step-up SIP. And the third part is, I'll always say, we have called as a CSIP, right? 100 times of your SIP amount, you get free insurance cover. So if you are below 52 years, man, our guys will tell you that, right? Or Mr. Nikhil can help you with that information. There is the age limit of 18 to 51 or 54. I think it is 54. I don't know. Just check it. Either it is 51 or 54. 100 times, for example, if you are doing a 20,000 SIP into 100, it will be 20 lakh is life insurance free. Till the age of 60, it is covered, right? So these are all coming free. So that way I can increase my insurance limit also. I think when it comes to SIP, I'll ask you to do these three things. It should be a perpetual SIP. It should be a 10% step up. And it should be a CSIP. I think if you do these three things, you are taken care of. And of course, the rebalancing part, please ensure that it is done once in a year.
Thank you. I think that step-up SIP is something which we forget, right? Because annual, if you are doing an average job itself, you will get about 10% hike.
Exactly. And that's what I'm saying.
And it's your question. It's your choice that whether you want to spend it or you want to save it.
Correct. And especially for a retirement, if you are going to do like that, you can really create a good corpus here.
I think if they are mindful to start at 30, I think that is there is other investment is not needed. And another thing is that one NRA, though, they're asking about 20 years, they are planning for a retirement. So they are advisable to go for equity and debt fund. And what is the tax aspect of debt mutual fund?
Yeah, so basically what happens is after 3 years, you have this indexation benefit there. Right. And for NRIs, there is another advantage. Flat 10% is also available only for NRIs. Right. That is where it is a huge benefit when it comes to it. And debt is something which you are going to continue, right, till 60 at least. So it is more used for a rebalancing rather than for anything else. So once in 3 years, if you are able to rebalance based on the status, we can decide whether to opt for 10% or indexation benefit. So you can calculate it and then decide. So that's where it's a huge benefit there. Yeah. And equity in any case, long term, it is 10% and you have that 1 lakh benefit. So nothing better than having this asset allocation of probably when you say 20 years, at least for the first 15 years, I will allocate anywhere between 70, 30 or 80, 20 based on your expenses, other expenses, how much you require. 70, 30 is safe. Otherwise, 80, 20 is also good. Yeah.
Good. There is another question. This is he's a 31 years old and planning to retire in another 10 years kind of thing, and looking for a regular income of 50,000 per month, and how much I should invest monthly now. I think in 10 years he need to get 50,000 per month SWP kind of thing. So that is
we can calculate the return and you can do it. Yeah, not an issue.
So I think
a couple of questions have come to me personally. I'll just take it. Mm-hmm. Is performing rebalancing using modern portfolio theory works? Forget all this theory was. I don't even understand all this, right? Rebalancing helps you to maintain that percentage. That's all. Mm-hmm. Whatever name you give it, you call it modern portfolio theory or whatever name you give it. For me, the answer is simple. I started with, let's say, 70-30. I have to maintain the 70-30. That is what I mean by rebalancing. Correct? So how does it happen? Say, for example, my 70% equity, tomorrow it has gone to 80%. I'm going to book that 10% and keeping it. This is what I mean by rebalancing. So that the ratio is 70-30 again. That's all we are talking of rebalancing. Yeah. I hope I answered your question.
Yes, sir. Yeah, my name is Sonu. But my question was, as we age up, right, we will be more to debt, right?
Correct.
So if I start early by around 30, I can go with 75% of the equity and 30% debt. But I continue investing to 20 years. If I am now in 50, then I need to move it to back to debt more, right?
Yeah, exactly. It will come to 60, 40, 50, 50, and finally it will be 80 in debt and 20 in equity. So it is a gradual process.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think Sonu.
So maybe you will call this as modern portfolio theory. I'm not giving a name to it. I'm just explaining in a practical angle. Yeah.
Yeah, because I see a lot of topics in YouTube regarding this statistics and.
Yeah. Don't even look at it. It doesn't make any sense to us. We should be worried about managing our money. Yeah. Okay. There is one more personal question to me, Vijin. He says Aditya Birla Sun Life Financial Planning Fund of Fund Moderate Plan good for 5-year investment. Because what is that you are looking at? Let's understand what is your requirement. When you say 5 years, let us understand for what goal you are saving. Then we'll be able to answer this question, right? Very important to understand for what goal you are doing it, right? You may say 5 years, but if it is a goal is something very important, I have to decide what is the equity exposure in that, right? So if the goal is, you should not lose your capital at all, then I will ensure that maybe I'll suggest a debt only for you. That's where we need to be very clear for what goal you are doing it. And based on that, we'll decide what is the equity allocation. And then if this is suitable, we'll recommend this also. Absolutely no problem on that. Yeah. You say buying bike. Now Vijin has answered, right? For buying bike, because in 5 years time, because you can definitely invest in a balance fund or even a balance advantage fund of kind of thing. It will give you more than FD return. That is good enough. Yeah, we can look at that.
I think these days buying a bike itself is a question.
Yeah. 5 years. Yeah. I'm really surprised.
You have a range.
5 years.
So
thanks, Vijin. Yeah. Thanks for asking that question. Yeah. Anything else you can take? These are okay. One more question. Sajil has asked me privately. Post retirement, which is advisable, corpus amount or monthly pension? Because if you are getting a monthly pension, nothing like it, right? Today, pension is not available for most of the sectors, correct? So that is where corpus is required. No government job is giving pension today. It is all over now. Any new government employee doesn't get pension. So by pension, if you are talking of annuity, then was definitely no. If you are saying pension as annuity, then definitely no. So you have to allocate some percentage to annuity, not everything. So I need a corpus. That is the answer.
I there is one more question. I think this is something which people may be interested. So when it comes to the expense ratio, ETF or mutual fund.
I think Sonu has also asked it privately. Yeah. See, the question here is, people think that ETF is better, right, from an expense point of view. Honestly, just go and check yourself. I don't want to accept whatever I'm saying. In March, when the markets corrected, you were not able to sell your ETF units. There were no buyers at all. Liquidity. March, especially that 23rd, that period, right? So each one has its own thing. So just for expenses, don't take that call. Just looking at the expenses, it should not happen when you needed money, you are not able to get it. Never get into it. Some portion of your money can go to ETF. I'm not questioning it. Whether all my money should go to ETF, definitely not. Some portion you invest in ETF, I'm fine with that, right? But entire money, should I do it in ETF? And how many ETFs are there?
Yeah,
the number of ETFs in India today are also limited.
Yes, sir. But the question was like we keep off many discussions in value research with Dhirendra, and some of the investors say that like even the Warren Buffett said like he's more preferred into index funds rather than the mutual funds.
Perfectly right. See, question here is ETF and index funds, again, slight difference is there. ETF, you need to have a demat account, you have to trade in the stock market, right? Though it is also an index fund. I'm not saying that, right? Now, the question here is, why index funds were suggested earlier was when the fund managers were not able to generate alpha. That is where in US market, they all moved to ETF long back, and today major trading is available in ETF, and they have a lot of ETFs. Unlike in India, we have very limited ETFs, right? One banking, one liquid, so limited number of ETFs. And there is not enough liquidity. When I say liquidity, especially in market is crashing that time, not in the general time. Otherwise, it is very liquid, no problem, right? But instead of that, you can definitely invest in our index funds. I don't have a problem. You can definitely go and invest in our index funds. Some part of it you want to allocate, because see, now people have a worry. But where is the fund manager role? I don't believe that my fund manager can generate alpha. If you are from that category of investors, for you, index funds will be better rather than index ETFs. Why I'm saying you need to have a demat account, and then there are problems in trading also. The price differential, we may say expenses are very low, right? But the buy and the sell price, if you look at the quotes, what you see, there is a impact cost there, right? Which people don't consider it. I have to consider that also when I'm, because I'll not be able to sell at the price what I want to. Whereas here, my NAV, it's absolutely calculated for the last 9 paise. So that is where there are advantages and disadvantages. So for me, if you are want to invest in index fund, yes, index fund also has an expenses of somewhere between 0.75 to 1%. You can invest in index fund. But I still believe we are not reached that stage where fund manager cannot generate alpha. We have still not reached that stage. That's where personally, I still believe you should invest in active funds. And if you're not comfortable with it, I'm absolutely fine. Invest in index funds. No problem with that. Don't go for ETFs. That's my personal suggestion. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. I think we have already we have crossed almost half an hour.
Yeah.
Planned. Thank you.
No issues. Absolutely no issues. I'd love to take the questions. Yeah.
I think we have almost touched everything. In case if you have any further question, you can write an email also, because there are few people ask the question personally. They have given their contact name and number also. So if any of you have any question, you can write to me, Nikhil@ Talks With Money. There we will give all the questions answered. In case if any specific question to Guruji sir also, I will personally get in touch with him. You're okay, right, sir?
No problem.
If he can, further get that question done. So, Daniel.
I will drop my email ID here. Yeah, they can mark it to you.
Yeah,
I'll prefer that they write to you first, because I keep getting engaged. It shouldn't happen ki they have any issues. I will reply definitely. Don't worry about it. Yeah.
No, I think, if you can, send it to both of us. This is a Guruji sir's official email ID, Aditya Birla Capital. And mine is given by Daniel, Nikhil@ Talks With Money. So a few of the questions I know that we haven't answered. Those questions, if you can write to us, or I will pick from here. And if your contact number is there, we will contact and give the answer, or we will write. So those who haven't received the answer, you can drop your email IDs. Accordingly, we will write that answer back. Or in case any questions related to money management or anything related to investment, you can write to us anytime, Nikhil@ Talks With Money. And our number, you know that in the YouTube channel, but don't really WhatsApp, because of too many questions, we are not able to give it on time. But in email, within a day or two, we will answer it without any issue. So that is what we can do. And we have, there is one more thing which sir said, things like in case all the document, all the investment, you have to keep it in a common place. So those things, we have created a database where you can put all your financial information. So you can come to our website, Talks With Money, and download that. Or you can mention that I want a document to note down all my investment, So that is where it's basically everything starts. What we have now. Once we know that what we have or what is our net worth, then we can plan goals and everything. So to start that, if you want that kind of template, you can send a email to us, and or you can go to the website and download that. So that is the way you can start your journey today itself. So today, so much of information you have got. And my request and our request is that start act today itself, because 1.5 hours you have invested for us, and you have gained a lot of knowledge. I'm sure that I personally learned a lot from you, right, sir? So I'm sure that before you step into this meeting and now, your knowledge is much higher than before, especially in terms of retirement. So start act. In case if you want any help, write to us. We are so happy to give that answer back.
Nikhil sir, I have just downloaded one file. Can I also have a look at this? Yeah, what my family should know.
Say something similar to this only.
You can also have it. And this is useful. And Nikhil, Nikhil sir, you can also add to it. Yeah. In case they can find whichever is useful.
Yeah, I think this is like you're talking about all this mutual fund.
Every data, literally data. Just go through it. Yeah, you will maintain everything almost.
Yeah, same thing.
If you can fill up all this, you are done with.
Simply share
that file with whomever you trust with. Yeah. I think
tomorrow is Sunday, and you should take a printout, and on your dining table with your family members, you should fill up this particular form. I think if you do that, your entire family finance will change.
Seriously. And keep visiting our websites also. We have a lot of information there. There is an investor education website in our Aditya Birla. Visit that. Lot of content is available. Videos, we have kept everything. I think I'm sure your knowledge will improve. Yeah. Please do that. And thanks, Nikhil sir, for such a wonderful crowd. And without your efforts, it would not have been possible. So we are grateful to you for arranging this. Yeah. And thanks to all the participants who stood with us patiently till now. Yeah. And though we intended to complete by 12, I think we have extended by another half an hour. But it was wonderful interacting with each one of you. And I wish that all of you remain safe with your family. That is very important at this point of time. Yeah. Over to you, Nikhil sir. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, guys, sir, for this entire session. And I think I owe you this half an hour extra also. Thank you so
my
much.
My pleasure. Yeah, my pleasure.
It's a great learning from a person who has been in this industry in, I think, all ups and down. I think more than close to 30 years. It is. It's a great thing, which I think. Almost our session, we had people just completed 30s. So their entire life experience you had, that is really wonderful to have. And I think what we are going to do is that this entire session we have recorded, and we will be uploading this in our YouTube video also. So if you think that you want to showcase this to your family members or loved one who think that this kind of session will be helpful, you can share this link also to them. So post the session, if you are registered, our team will call up and send you this and their recording to you also. So that is also will be helpful for you. Okay. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you, Rai sir, for
coming. Thanks. My pleasure.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I think the team of Kochi, Aditya Birla, they have taken a great effort to connect you and organize this session. So especially thank you to Jitu Xavier. I don't know whether he's there in this system. Then Ram, who is also taken the time to conduct the session. So let us see that if we can conduct a similar kind of session in the future. Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you, everyone, for coming in. Thank you, everyone. Yeah, bye.